All right, happy Tech Tip Tuesday. So today we're going to talk about screen materials. So most people aren't aware that if you're doing front projection, so in other words, you're doing a projector shooting across onto a surface, what's really important is what that surface is. In our 15 years, in my 18 years in the business, we've heard people shoot it on plain walls, on textured walls. They went and bought custom screen paint. I have a confession. 15 years ago, I painted a section on my wall and tried it. And I thought it was good until I actually saw screen material. So when you're looking at that screen material and your projection system, what you're going to use, remember the screen material is just as, if not more important than the projector itself. Because as crazy as this sounds, and stick with me here as we go a little bit technical, what you're actually seeing when you're watching front projection is not the image on the wall. What you're actually seeing is whatever is being reflected back into your eyes. That's the image that we actually see. So if you think about that, that means that material is critical. If it absorbs reds and doesn't reflect them back well, then your image will be weak in reds. If that wall surface you're shooting onto has a very, very high absorption of blacks, then you're going to have a very hard time getting true blacks into that image. An example would be a plain white surface. Plain white is obviously really hard to produce black. So the other thing we want to remember is that when we're looking at that screen material, when the projector is off, whatever color you see, whatever brightness you see on that image, that is your black, right? Because projectors can't produce black, they can only produce white. They're only able to produce light, not remove it. So in your room, if that screen looks very white, there's as black as you're going to get and as black as the image is going to get. So what we've seen is a huge shift in our industry where now screen materials, we're not just seeing gray screens because gray screens can interfere with white. What we're instead seeing are some screens that are referred to as a black screen, okay? I brought a sample with me. A sample would be something like this. This is a Screen Innovations black diamond material. So if you notice, it is significantly darker than a standard white or a gray screen. The fun part about this, and you can see it as I tilt it, you'll actually see the screen change color. The reason is this screen is actually made up of multiple layers and it filters surrounding light. So as I turn the image or turn the screen material, you can actually see it change in intensity. So these materials are actually designed for when the projection light hits them, that light will reflect back to your eyes, the ambient light coming from above or coming from the sides doesn't interfere with that. Point being that when you're looking at front projection, keep in mind what material you're shooting that onto. The material can in some situations be even more important than the projector itself. Another tip for you, when you're looking at making that selection between your screen and your projector, remember that your projector, contrary to what you think, you're probably going to replace it within the next 3 to 7 years. Your projection material, that lasts forever. And in fact, all we've seen is screen materials go up in price. So if you're trying to decide, you have a little bit left in your budget, you're trying to decide, do I put it on the screen or do I put it on the projector? Put it on the screen, okay? Because that screen is going to last, so to speak, forever. All right? Any other tips? Comment down below. Questions? Let us know. Love to help you guys out. Again, Eric with The Loop Technologies. Thank you and have a great day.